Are you still hesitating in going on a solo trip? I'm sure you're not hesitating in going on a trip. You've been dying for it, right? But if you're hesitating in going on a solo trip, don't. Today I'm going to tell you how, and I'm going to share all the tips I have so that you can enjoy your next best solo trip. Let's go. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Lydia here. If you're new to this channel, in this channel, I just usually share some of the experience and tips that I have built up in the past 2 years by building up a healthy routine and by going to the gym, by reading more books. And occasionally I share some of the things that I love in Hong Kong, the cafes that I go to and the restaurants that I enjoy. In today's video, I'm just going to tell you all the tips that I have for the solo trip. Tip number one, never ever distract when you're changing your SIM card. When I was changing my SIM card, it slipped into the SIM card holder. You know, there's a space in your phone that you actually want to put your SIM card first on a SIM card holder and then put a SIM card holder into the phone, right? I guess I was just too excited to get off the plane and I was somehow distracted. So the SIM card slipped into the phone. Oh, you just stuck there. And I used the stingy thing where you use to change your SIM card to get it out, and it somehow ruined my phone. So long story short, I have to book an appointment at the airport by using the airport Wi-Fi while still waiting at the custom. The Apple store is actually the first place that I visit in Madrid after I got to the hotel. And the Apple store, guess what? They couldn't fix it. I spent 2 hours trying to find a nice bodega that fixed everything. Searched YouTube videos, hoping to figure out on my own. By the time I almost lost hope and was like, maybe I just buy another new iPhone. Just at the time I almost lost hope, I stumbled across to a bodega and find out that the son of the owner, he's actually working on a mobile phone store. I just took a cab and I went to the store and directly gave my phone to him. At the end of the day, I can use the Wi-Fi and data plan that my company phone has, which is unlimited. I started my day 6 hours later than I should have. So number one tip for you guys, when you travel solo, never ever distract when you're changing your SIM card, because the phone is when you travel solo. You need that for like booking tickets and talk to people, looking for information. So just don't distract. Number two, how to take photos. Photos is a big part about any kind of travels. I guess you have this question in your mind, how am I supposed to take photos when I'm travel solo, right? And that's one of my questions when I started my solo trip. I was like, heck, I was just gonna take selfies all the time. Here's one tip. If you want to take selfies, of course you can buy a selfie stick and whatever. See, I ended up taking a lot of selfies, but hey, there are some photos, very good ones as well. Asking people to take photos for you is actually not that hard. I'm going to share two tips that I found it useful. The first idea is, actually there are a lot of people always around you. You can always ask people to take photos for you. Say for example, the people at the coffee shop, the people at the restaurants, they are the experts, right? They take photos for travelers, that they take photos with people who on their special occasions all the time. If you happen to be able to talk to people who are in the same traveling group with you, if you kind of click in the conversation, they're also usually the ones who share the same aesthetic mindset with you, and they usually take very good photos for you. If they travel in a smaller group, they will be very happy to take photos for you. So to sum up, you can start it from the very basic, the people who serve you at the restaurants, the people you talk to at the cafe, and the tour guides that you follow on the tour group. The second layer is whoever that you talk to, you find that in the conversation you actually click. That's where you start. I will rate it as ease of execution, 4 stars. The reward is 3 stars. You actually get good photos, but it's very hard to say. The second tip is you can offer help. Many people wouldn't really think that, but there is a saying goes, offer what you want to receive, right? When people are on the go, when they're traveling by themselves or they're traveling in a couple, they're dying for other people to offer help, get a good photo for them. This photo was actually on top of the tower of Sagrada Familia, where I was about to finish the tour and I was like, I didn't get a photo on top of Sagrada Familia. And I saw this kindest couple. I think that they're trying to take photos of themselves. And then I reached out to them. I was like, oh, do you need a photo? I can help it to take it for you. And after I take photos for them, they offer help to take photos for me as well. How great is that? Because everybody is dying to help other people, actually. Deep down in our hearts, we are really kind human beings. We want to help other people, and that's what makes us feel good about ourselves. So offer help, help others, and give a chance for others to help you. I would say that the ease of execution is 3 stars. It's not very easy, because first you need to bump into people who want to take photos, and then you need to quickly assess. Maybe, yeah, say they rejected you, you lose nothing, right? You're just like, ask one sentence. Do you need help? Do you want me to take a photo for you guys? And that's it. If they say yes, and you're going to have a great experience. I ended up talking to the old couple, and then they helped me take another photo when we went down to the main hall of Sagrada Familia. And I came to know where they're from, and we went down the stairs all together. We'll say the reward is 4 stars. First, congratulations, you walk out of your comfort zone. You actually take the courage to talk to other people. And the second, you're going to have pretty good photos that you're going to use it for several years. That's the second tip about taking photos. First, you can just ask people to help you who are in a more natural settings, like the people that you travel with, the people that you come across in the cafe or the restaurant. Second is that you can just offer help to who need help, and they can actually appreciate your help and also counter offer your help. So the third tips, how to get recommendation. I would say the best way is just to talk to people. It sounds super duper easy, right? But just talk to all the locals you come across, no matter those are the ones at the local store or those are at the gym or the receptions. But maybe the receptions at the hotels are a little bit more. The advice they have depends on what kind of advice you want to have. If you want to travel like a local, I just outright tell them, I want to go to the places that local go to. What's the top 3 restaurants that you love the most? What's the latest and the newest restaurant? What's the up and trendy neighborhood? You're going to get pretty good advice, especially when they're really proud and passionate about their own cities. They're even going to write down everything and tell you what to do next. So it's a great way. The final tip, last but not least, is to learn a few phrases in the language. I love this quote from Trevor Noah's book, is how he interprets language. Nelson Mandela once said, if you talk to a man in a language he understands, that goes to his head. If you talk to him in his language, that goes to his heart. He was so right. When you make the effort to speak someone else's language, even if it's just basic phrases here and there, you're saying to them, I understand that you have the culture and identity that exists beyond me. I see you as a human being. Just learn a few phrases. Things like hello in English. To this day, I still remember hola, como estás, bien, muy bien, adiós, gracias. Gracias, mucho gracias. That's like the most frequent phrases by the end of the 14th days of my solo trip in Spain. People are like, oh, your Spanish is pretty good. No, I was just like, I only picked up a few phrases. We oftentimes feel shy on how some languages we don't know about. But if you flip the thinking, will you ever laugh at the people who are trying to just to learn a few phrases in your language? You're not. You're going to feel deep down in your heart, feel very warm about the people who are trying so hard. So if, especially when you're traveling solo, a few phrases and a sincere smile will get you to many places. Well, side note, I don't remember since when I started to be very curious about language. I think that trip actually solidified the curiosity that I have for all the languages. Now I'm learning all different kinds of language. The last part, the general checklist that I found helpful, and hopefully it's going to be helpful for you too. First, about your bag. For me, first, you need to be functional, which means that you can put into all my necessities into the bag, like the phone, the power bank, necessary documents, and all the stuff. And the second, you need to be safe. You know, when you're traveling or you want some bags that actually can safely you can zip so that nobody can just take something from your bag. Remember to bring your power bank so that your phone is always alive. Then you, whenever you need to check something, you can actually do. Yeah, that's it. That's the 4 tips that I have. So now sum up. First is don't distract when you change your SIM card. Then second is how to make sure that you are going to have your photo with to remember this memory. And the third one is learn a few phrases in the local language. The last thing is about the checklist, what kind of bags that you want to have, and just remember to bring all the things that you need. So hopefully that will be helpful tips for your next solo trip. If you like this video, please hit subscribe, share it with your friends, give me a thumbs up. You can also follow me on Instagram. I'm going to share a lot more about this beautiful Hong Kong here. I'll see you next time. Bye.